All right, a number of our visitors have very strong memories of swimming at Victoria Baths. And I'll tell you the story from the point of view of one of the boys who would be here. They would change, and before there were showers, the boys used to wash the feet in troughs. The attendants would make sure that they'd do that because they were dirty little urchins, not as clean as we are nowadays. And when showers were introduced at the baths, they were cold showers. And I've got friends who remember that you would go in the trough, wash your feet, then go in the shower, and even though they were cold, you'd stay there for as long as you could, because the swimming pool, by comparison, would feel warm. So the boys would swim, play, maybe get a little bit cold. And the warmest place in the baths was back in the trough. And they'd sit one behind the other, tight in there. And of course, the water was a bit gloopy. There'd be the carbolic soap, dirty little boys. And then the attendants would turn on the hot water to get them out. It'd be too hot for them to sit in there. So then they'd go through the same cycle of have the cold shower back in the pool, unless the attendants found that the fingers were all wrinkly. And if they were so wrinkly, they'd had their time and they'd be thrown out. Now, that is a strong memory that I share with our visitors, and a number of people remember it. In fact, I had somebody earlier today who'd swum at Arpare Baths, and that was how it went on there.
Tell me about how the first and second class used to work, because it's slightly different then to what it is now, isn't it?
Okay, first and second class, it was done on the basis of price, and we also had clean days and dirty days at the baths, so it's a very complex price structure. Let's start with the first class. It was sixpence to swim on a clean day, but the water didn't have any preservatives, so it was fresh water. And because of the number of users, and maybe they weren't as clean, then the water would be changed after 4 days. So it was sixpence on a clean day, but as the water was getting dirty, it was fourpence on a dirty day. And then in the male second class, it was fourpence and twopence. So there was a difference in price. Sixpence on a clean day in the first class, fourpence on a clean day in the second class. But I'm sure there were also other issues about swimming, that if an ordinary lad had his sixpence, maybe the Edwardian gents who were swimming in there might not welcome him so much, so would probably not be given the kind of welcome that he would hope for.